हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द वेली सी डिजाइन कोर्स। सो वी हैव नाउ क्रिएटेड यूजर कंस्ट्रेंट फाइल ऑफ आवर VLSI और VHDL डिजाइन। नाउ नेक्स्ट स्टेप इज टू डू द प्लेसमेंट एंड राउटिंग ऑन द FPGA एंड देन फर्दर इम्प्लीमेंट ऑन द FPGA। So till now we have completed the various steps using Xilinx IIC, like creating a project, simulate the design, see its simulation waveforms, then synthesize the design, view the RTL view as well as the technology mapping, technology map view. Then we have assigned the constraint file so that internal logic we can connect to our external interface, like we can control the input through switches by giving logic 0, logic 1 and observing the particular response on the LED. So that much we have done till now. Now this design we have to implement on the or do we have to perform a placement and routing on the FPGA. So let us start. What is mean by placement and routing? So placement and route is a stage in the design of FPGA, or it is one of the step in the VLSI design flow. As implied by the name itself, it is composed of the two steps, placement and the routing. So I'll give one of the example. You know, when we are designing our own like house or something like that, so in that we have a architecture, we have a plan like that. We wanted to place, let us say in house we have to place our bedroom somewhere, we wanted to place our hall somewhere and kitchen somewhere. So like that arrangement is called as the placement. So where we wanted to keep the entry point, exit point, and accordingly we are planning it. So same planning happens in the FPGA placement. The FPGA architecture consists of the IO blocks as well as the CLBs. So inside each configurable logic block there are slices, and inside each slice there are LUTs, shift register, flip-flops and other logical blocks. So in the placement, FPGA is a partition in a such a way that our logical implementation happens to particular blocks. Why it is important? Because again, there in a complex design, clock routing also plays an important role. So to reach the clock input to every flip-flop input should have a at the same time. So it is also called as a clock skew. So it should not create any delay while going clock from input from external reference input to the each flip-flop input. So in that case, this placement and routing plays a very important role. The process of placing and routing for an FPGA is generally not performed by the person because it is a complex thing. It is done by this using this EDA tools. The need for software tool is because of the complexity of the circuit within the FPGA and function the designer wishes to perform. So how this placement happens? So if you can see, FPGA architecture is designed such a way that internal blocks are CLBs, configurable logic block, their actual or digital block sits or where digital logics are sitting, and it is surrounded by the input output blocks. So these are the input output blocks are nothing but our input output pins where we can connect our external environment signal to this IO blocks. So first of all, we have to plan its placement. So again, it is divided. It depends on the application, whether it is a purely analog function, digital, or some analog functionality we have to separate out. It depends on the application. So accordingly, let us say we have placed our design in specific blocks, then comes the routing. So in FPGA, routing is done through this switch matrix. So it has a connectivity to connect with the CLB. Now we cannot fit all the logics in one CLB. It has many CLBs where other gates, other flip-flops are residing, and so we have to connect through other CLBs also. This switch matrix is used. So this is something like we can say a connecting box where each and every CLB can be connected through this switch, or using this switch matrix 1 to switch matrix 2, it can be connected and routed from across the corner. So for example, this CLB, I wanted to connect the corner of this CLB. So internal, this will be, can be routed through multiple switch matrices and be connected to this CLB. So like this routing is happening. A set of discrete wire segment in an FPGA device that can be connected together to form a routing path. That is the meaning of routing domain. So this is a small description about placement and routing. Now we will see how exactly tools are performing the placement and routing. So for that purpose, now let us say our design is ready. We have done the synthesis, we have done the technology mapping also. Now to place and route our design in the ISA, we have option implement design. So during this implement phase, it will translate, map and place and route our design. So let us perform it, implement design. So it will start implementing the design. It will first translate our design, then map it. We can observe the console here, what are the activities going at the back end. One thing I forget to tell you, whenever we are doing any steps in the design summary, we can observe here various reports. So synthesis message or any other reports as well. Synthesis report already we have completed, so let's look at it. So synthesis report gives us the number of utilization of resources. So our design utilizes number of slices, 2 out of 704 are available in that FPGA, 4 input LUTs, 3 number of IO, so total 5 IOs we are using because 2 input, 3 output, as well as it shows us the lookup table. Okay, LUT2 already covered. So this is something like a synthesis report where we can get a complete statistics of our design. Now our design implementation done, so translate, mapping, placement and routing done. Now we'll see how this placement and routing is looks like. So we can view or edit routed design. So let us see it, how it looks like. So these are the some blocks. This is switch matrix. Okay, so if you see here, so our block is placed in this CLB. So in this CLB, our logical design is placed and then it is routed. So let us see one by one if where it is placed, and as well as if you see, so this is something like placement. So here our design is placed. This is clock tree, text, wires. Okay. So this is local lines. Okay, we can enable, disable. So using these tools, we can observe it, our placement and routing. Placement and routing. These are the routes. This is not important. So like this, our design is placed in this CLB and it is routed to our external pin connections. So if you see here, we have given the IO pins. If you remember our user constraint, so here sites also they have mentioned P31, P32. And after that, there is input buffer. These outputs are connected with the output buffers, IO buffers. So all these details are available in this tool. So once this is done, now next step is to generate a executable or generate a programming file. Generate a program. So it will generate a bit file for this particular FPGA, or it will create a bit file our development board. So let's generate it. And then we'll see how to implement it on the FPGA board and see the performance. Or we can validate our design by giving real-time input signals like logic 0, logic 1 and observing the functionality. So our bit file is also generated. So once this bit file is generated, we have to use the FPGA programmer. So the development board we have that can be programmed through the USB. So we can connect USB to our system and program the FPGA. So that all things now we are covering in our next lecture. Thank you.